sure, Pop.
I've got to hand it to you, son, for some smart figuring. Come on, let's get it out of here.
Hey, wait a minute. That doesn't feel right.
Rocks.
Stand here. Let's start digging them out.
It's tough, Bolton. We couldn't reach them now.
Coming, Bolton?
No. First, I'm going to find the gang that did this and wipe them out. They must be around here someplace. Well, are any of you going with me?
Yeah, we're with you, Bolton.
All right, you two take that side. Come on with me.
Lucky thing that old cribbing wasn't strong enough to hold that dirt.
You still got the spare play, Clay?
Huh? Well, it might be a drift of the old pocket mine.
Yeah. Well, anyway, it's got to come out somewhere.
Go ahead and take a look. See if the Paratron's in any of those boxes.
Do is get past a half a dozen outlaws.
Right.
Down there, about 100 feet. Hey, where's that guard?
No, don't worry about him. He's all tied up and tucked away.
Good. You ready?
Yeah, we'll have to shoot our way out of
here. And with one gun. I wish I'd...
Paratron, I'm worried about.
have plenty of ammunition anyway, Pop. Here, you better stock up.
Here they come again. Look at those crazy fools, lighting torches so we can see them better.
Crazy, are they?
I mean crazy like Pop.
In a dark alley. Wonder what they're up to now. I'll see.
Well, you saw.
Figure we'd never look for him up here. Go back and get the others.
We gotta get those flares out of here. You take the one over there, and I'll get this one over here.
Come in, B.R. I know all about your blundering.
We can't stay here. Hudson will come back and forth and wipe us out.
Hudson won't be there because you're going to get him fresh.
I don't follow you.
Listen, you'll be standing by gunside mine with your men. At the proper time, House will turn the Paratron on the mine. In the confusion, your men will go in and finish the job.
The end of my rope. I can't work under these conditions. Violence, fighting, murder.
Where are you going, Doctor?
To see Hudson. I'm going to make arrangements to take the Paratron back to Seattle at once.
Please, Doctor, don't act in haste.
I've made up my mind.
A message come in from Brock. Turn the Paratron on the mine buildings. Destroy everything you can, and be sure you get the Hudsons.
What about me?
Brandon is standing by. The explosion and fire will be his signal to attack.
I could do it right now. They're all in the house.
Now would be a bad time to move the Paratron.
Why?
I can't promise anything. I just have a feeling things are coming to a climax.
And when they do, what will happen to the Paratron, to all my work?
We'll have to take that chance. Just hope to strike before they do.
And I still say we ought to go back to Pocket with the Marshal and his men and wipe them out.
And I still say they're not going to sit there waiting for us.
So you think your plan will work?
I'm sure of it. It's only a matter of days. Maybe hours.
Relax, boys. Nothing yet.
Busy, Doctor?
Yes, I'm very busy.
What are you doing?
Dr. Miller and I are about to conduct an experiment. So if you'll excuse me.
Oh, sure. Go right ahead. Don't mind if I watch, do you?
Dr. Miller is in a rather nervous state.
Uh-huh. Too much excitement, huh?
If you please.
Mm-hmm. I scared you, didn't I?
Thought it was water.
Of course not, you fool. Leave those chemicals alone, or you blow us all up.
Yeah, well, I guess I'll be going.
Thank you very much.
Oh, you're welcome. Hello.
Why is it loaded? What are we doing?
We were about to measure the speed of the life beam.
Oh yes.
I have been making preparations.
I see.
What did Mr. Hudson say to your leaving?
Well, we'll wait a few days and see what develops.
There are several angles we're sure of. That radio message that fooled us into going to the abandoned mine was obviously a trap. And secondly, that outlaw who told us of the radio was prompted to do so while he was right here. Because naturally, he didn't figure on being captured at the hideout.
So it was an inside job. He got it from one of our men.
None of the miners was in the house, Pop. Nobody had a chance to talk to him.
Say, Jim. The boys are taking the cream of that hot quartz out right now. I thought you'd like to see it.
You bet.
That quartz is another reason why the doctor ought to stick around.
Coming, Ruth?
Yes, I will. I don't think I should go down, Jim. Dad worries me.
Well, your father's all right. We'll only be gone about 20 minutes. Come on.
Well, all right.
There you go.
We'll direct the beam through the window against the hill and measure the speed that way.
No, that way you won't get the distance, Doctor. Besides, it is too dangerous. I suggest we take the Paratron outside and direct the beam into the sky, where it can do no harm.
You're quite right. It was very thoughtful, something. I'll get a couple of boys to help us.
Seems to be getting stronger the deeper we go.
What are we stopping here for?
I wanted to show you the difference in the quartz on this top level.
You're not getting the stuff out fast enough. Put the men on a double shift.
Do we get a bonus?
You're getting too much overtime already.
Don't mind him. You'll get your bonus.
I believe the array will reach 20,000 feet. Now we'll see.
There's the beam. Stand by, men, any minute now.
Give it more juice.
We're depending on you to get the ore out.
I'll get it out.
Okay, Pop.
target set. As soon as the Paratron blasts the mine, that's when we attack. There's the beam. Stand by, men, any minute now.
$15,000. Give it more juice.
We're depending on you to get the ore out.
I'll get it out.
Okay, Bob.
The difference in the quartz on this top level.
You're not getting the stuff out fast enough. Put the men on a double shift.
Do we get a bonus?
You're getting too much overtime already.
Don't mind him. You'll get your bonus.
What's that?
Follow me, quick. Up this ladder.
Under control. Come on, Grant.
I wonder if Dad's all right.
Exactly, no, it was so quick. I heard the shots fired and then somebody hit me from behind. When I came to, the shaft house was inflamed and Dr. Miller was lying beside me, unconscious. So I brought him in here.
Joe, we better get him upstairs.
Trusted men, too.
Kessel. Bosun, are you sure?
Why, I saw it with my own eyes.
Then this must be the man who attacked Dr. Miller and myself.
Come on, sit back and make yourself comfortable. Now tell us all about it.
Might as well talk, Kessel. Who's behind this? Who sent you here? Who's paying you?
Come on, start singing before I work on you again.
Why'd you do that?
He wanted to kill me. I lost my head. I'm all confused. I don't know anymore what I'm doing. I'm sorry.
Pop, there's your man that's been working from the inside.
Well, it's about time.
Kessel.
Why?
Like House did his stuff. This ought to be easy.
Huh. It's them high binders again.
Come on, man!
Oh.
Get a couple of rifles.
Take it inside.
What are you going to do with that?
Use it in the art log.
I'll leave it where it was.
I said this is going to be easy. I had a hunch House would bungle this deal.
Thanks, Pop.
Well, that's the last of this gang.
I hope so, but we better make sure.
Well, boys, the smokes are on me. Light your own cigarettes.
And get back to work! What do you think this is, a first aid party?
I'm sorry you wouldn't let me use a paratron on them.
That's too bad.
Maybe you better go outside and see if they got them all.
Members of this gang still around. Sooner or later, they'll be back.
I agree with you, Doc. I think you should take the Paratron and return to the States.
And I shall accompany the doctor, of course.
Certainly, Dr. House.
Well, fine. I'll load the Paratron in the station wagon and get things ready for you.
Thank you, Jim.
You know, Doc, for your sake, I'm glad you're gone. But it's going to be awful quiet around here.
When are we leaving?
Immediately. You are to drive me to town with the Paratron. Dr. Miller will follow in the other car.
All right, check and see if we got everything.
Sorry to have kept you gentlemen waiting.
See you later, Bosun.
Stop the car.
Put that thing away. You could kill a guy with that.
Stop this car.
what happened to you? You were supposed to go on into town.
Well, he pulled a gun on me.
Well, it wasn't quite according to plan, was it? You know, that might work out even better. Does he know we're following him?
I don't think he suspects a thing.
Well, get in.
Did you have to come straight to my office after that showdown at the mine?
Where should I have gone?
Never mind. The thing now is to get you and that Paratron out of town fast before the Hudsons come looking for it. So, this is what I spent all those weeks trying to get, is it? Let's have a look at it. You stupid imbecile!
Went into Brock's office. I can't understand it.
What's so strange about that?
Well, I don't see how Brock could be involved. He's the most respected man in town.
Did you expect him to be wearing a stormtrooper's uniform?
Well, hardly, but we gotta be sure. Look, Ruth, Brock's secretary knows me, but she doesn't know you. Why don't you go in there and ask her if Dr. House is with Brock? Will you do that?
Why not?
I came into town with Dr. Houts. He told me to meet him here.
I see. Well, he's in with Mr. Brock just now. Shall I tell him you're here?
Oh, no, don't bother. I have some shopping to do anyway. I'll drop back later. Thank you.
Yes?
Miss Miller was looking for Dr. House.
How do you know this, Miss Miller?
From Brandon's description of her.
Did you tell her House was here?
Yes.
How long ago?
Just now.
Well, it becomes clearer every minute. You've walked into a beautiful little trap.
But what are we to do? Brandon and his men are gone.
Shut up!
No one left but us.
Deputy Marshal's office, please.
Why did you call the Marshal? You're mad.
Hello, Marshal? This is Brock speaking. There's a troublemaker on his way here to annoy me. I'd like to have you take care of him for me. You will? Thank you. I guess that'll take care of the Hudsons.
I don't see how.
They've suffered serious losses lately. Trucks, buildings, planes. They've become involved with a dangerous maniac named Miller, who has an inferno machine killing and destroying with it.
Will the Marshal believe that?
In this town, people believe what I tell them and do what I say.
Well, he isn't the first big shot who's a fascist at heart.
There's one sure way of finding out. Come on, Bosun.
We should be leaving town, not sitting here, waiting.
To leave town now would be the worst possible thing we could do.
I want to see Brock.
He's in conference now. You'll have to wait.
I've waited long enough. Hold on, Jim. What's got into you? I want to see Brock. Yeah, that's what he told me. Maybe you better come with us and simmer down. I'm not going with anybody till I see Brock.
Oh, hello, Jim. Glad to see you. There's your man, Marshal.
That one?
Of course. He came in here and tried to sell me an invention he'd stolen from Dr. Miller and the Hudsons. I got wise and arranged this little meeting.
Brock. No. You don't believe him, do you?
Not quite. I think you must have had a pretty good reason to believe that Mr. Brock would even be interested.
Well, just the other day, your own father sent this man to me with a letter of introduction.
Traitor. Shot is too easy for him. In my country, he would have suffered for this coward.
Take him out of here and lock him up.
What's it all about? Why don't somebody tell me something?
This man's a spy.
What?
He's in the pay of the enemy. So is Brock and his whole gang. You'll find out about it soon enough. Go on, get him out of here.
No, I'm not angry. I'm just peeved. Because you didn't tell me you were suspicious of House.
Oh, so you're the one woman in the world who can keep a secret, huh?
I am.
What, for instance?
The date I've set for our wedding, for instance.
Suppose the marshal told you to hold me as a material witness.
Material witness?
Yes.
I don't know anything about the witness. But if you ask me, babe, you're certainly good material.